The ocean is an incredibly complex place, but it's dictated by all these tiny processes that happen at extremely small scales. Our research is able to build bridges between these really tiny molecular scales all the way up to understanding the ocean as a whole and its role in the climate system. I am Benjamin Van Mooy, and I'm an oceanographer. Plankton are microscopic organisms that live in seawater. Plankton form the very basis of the food web and feed all of the ocean. If we look at the molecules that are inside these plankton called lipids, and lipids are fat molecules. These fats are a really important source of energy and nutrients for organisms in the ocean. What we're finding is that as the ocean warms, plankton may be making fewer and fewer of those healthy, unsaturated lipids. One cell may have a billion molecules in it. These molecules have an impact on how we understand the fate of that carbon in the upper ocean and in the food web. Phytoplankton play a really critical role in the carbon cycle, and that's because they conduct photosynthesis. When phytoplankton take up that carbon dioxide, it creates a draw on carbon dioxide from the atmosphere, and some of those phytoplankton may die and sink into the deep sea. And that's what we call the process of natural carbon sequestration. The movement of carbon from CO2 in the atmosphere through the surface ocean and then down into the deep sea. So one of the central questions that oceanographers are working on right now is understanding how much carbon dioxide the oceans can take up. Carbon dioxide is increasing in the atmosphere due to human activity. And it turns out that about a quarter of all the carbon dioxide that would have been released by human activities has actually been soaked up by the ocean. And plankton are playing a huge role in that. Ultimately, that's where I view our work as really feeding into a broader understanding of the role of the ocean in the climate system.